Hey everyone, this is a really interesting product and I really could have used this last year when I was running cables around my house like a madman. And that's because this is the RUIPRO 8K Detachable Pure Fiber HDMI cable. Bit of a mouthful, but actually it's a really useful product because let's say you wanted to run a HDMI cable around your house, maybe into your walls and up into your loft or under some carpets. The problem you'll find is that actually the HDMI cable end is really big and bulky, and that means that any holes you're going to drill need to be big and bulky to accommodate the end of that HDMI cable. But with this, you don't need to do that because you run a fiber cable and the end of the fiber cable is a lot smaller, and then it has detachable ends. So you can then put on the HDMI 2.1B end onto the actual fiber cable, and it just means that, you know, you're only making smaller holes to run the fiber cable, but ultimately you still get that HDMI functionality. And the beauty of this being a detachable model is that in the future, if there's like HDMI 3 or HDMI 99, as long as this fiber cable is still in good operation, you can actually switch at the end and then upgrade from HDMI 2.1 to HDMI 3 or whatever else. So I wanted to actually unbox this in this video, and then at the end I'm actually going to do a short demo of this product. Okay, so it just comes in some plastic wrap, easy enough to remove, and then you've actually got this particular bit of tape that we need to just cut. Now in theory we can open up this box. Yes we can, there we are. So you've got some Q-tips, which we'll look at in a minute, the user manual, which we'll talk through because this isn't really something you're going to want to mess around with. So that's the user manual, and then you actually come to the cables as a whole. And then you've actually got this foam insert just to protect things in transit, and actually this box as a whole, you know, the packaging and everything else, it does feel quite premium. And before I show off the products in more detail, I just wanted to talk through the details on the box a little bit more. So it just mentions, again, it's a pure fiber optic cable with detachable ends, and as it stands, they've actually sent HDMI 2.1B supporting ends, which means, you know, you get dynamic HDR support for 8K 60Hz uncompressed or 4K 120Hz if you wanted that. And because it's fiber optic, you're not going to have any, you know, signal loss, and it's not affected by EMF, electromagnetic interference, so that is really cool. So that is the box, and I'll show you these products now, but then I'm going to jump into the user manual just so you know what you're getting into, because yeah, you don't really want to mess up the fiber optic ends, because then, you know, the detaching and everything else might not work. But this is the actual cable. It's a good quality fiber cable, you know, it's bendy without being too bendy and everything else. And then you've got the actual ends, which obviously are protected, and there's a little warning there saying, you know, please make sure it's protected. But this is the actual cable. It comes with three cable ties, and then yeah, that is the cable. This is 50 feet or 15 meters, just because that was the best length for me. But you can get shorter cables or even longer cables if you really want that. And then in the box as well, you've got this.
A few moments later.
Which are your ends. And again, there's warning stickers on these because they're going to be really sensitive, you know. And again, it says, yeah, please do not remove the warning stickers before installation. So that will be your HDMI end. It's blue, you know, it's HDMI 2.1 and all that, or 2.1B actually. And then you've got the fiber end. So the idea is, you know, you will actually be plugging these fiber ends in together when you're actually ready. But because of the length of this cable, you actually need to supply it with additional power. And you get this as well with like USB 3 and other things. Like I run a USB 3 cable last year, and because of its length, I needed to give it extra power. So actually I'd plug in a USB 3, the cable I actually run, but also a USB 2 to actually provide additional power. And that's what you get here as well. So you can see on this diagram that actually there are these little extension cables. Basically you've got a standard, you know, USB-A, and you plug this into the header, and that is the actual thing that provides the power and the functionality. That is the actual cable. Then you get some Q-tips, and then you've got the user manual, and it says, please read this user manual carefully before use. Although you could probably imagine what you're gonna do with this. It is the sort of thing, I think it is worth, you know, checking the manual just to make sure you don't do anything wrong. So I'm just gonna show you the manual. So yeah, that's with stickers and covers. And obviously that's the diagram if you actually remove the stickers. And then it just gives you your installation steps. So the first thing it says is, please actually run this particular cable, but please make sure you do it carefully. Don't remove the actual dust covers, these actual things, while you're actually running things. And then please don't bend the cable too sharply. And that is worth knowing, because obviously, you know, you can have a bend like that, that would be fine. But if you know, if it's a really, really tight bend, then that can actually damage the glass or the plastic inside it. Because remember, this is a fiber optic cable, you know, it's not copper that you could bend a decent amount. So yeah, that is actually running the cable. It says, please don't bend the cables too sharply. And then once you've run it through your conduit or through your walls or under your carpets, the next thing you can actually do is plug in the ends, which is what this is. And I'll show you with just one end, and then I'm gonna go on to a live demo just so we can see this working. So that is the HDMI end, which is exposed there, and that is that. And then basically you will plug it in. And you need to make sure you do it carefully. You know, you shouldn't put too much force on it. You shouldn't put too little force on it either. But you know, if it's not going in at all, don't brute force it in. It might be you've got it upside down or something like that. But that is now connected. And if I ever did want to release it in the future, I can pull this back and detach it again. And as I mentioned in the intro, if, you know, HDMI 3 comes out in the future, the beauty of this particular model is once my cable is run in conduit or under my carpet or in the walls, I can just change the end, which is really, really clever. And then this particular product comes with a lifetime warranty, assuming you haven't done something really stupid with it, which is all the details there, but it doesn't cover misuse and, you know, all of that stuff. Next, I'm gonna do a demo and let's check it out. Okay, I'm gonna keep this demo fairly simple because I didn't really fancy hauling all my equipment downstairs for the TV, but this monitor is not plugged into anything. I've removed any other cables, and it does have a free USB port in terms of powering it. So this is equivalent to a TV really. And I'm gonna hook it up to my Dell monitor. That has a HDMI port. Okay, so that's gonna be my fiber cable, which is a really cool idea. Next, I'm gonna plug it in under here, which is gonna be a bit of a faff, so bear with me. That's the USB, and that is the HDMI. Right, that's a bit of a faff, but there we are, that is now plugged in. Now I've got my HDMI end that can simply go into the laptop, so nice and simple. So let me turn this on and see it work, hopefully. Okay, so the laptop is turned on, but not the monitor, but I'll log in and check the display settings because it's probably something like that. Multiple displays. Detect other display. We couldn't find your other display. Okay, that's a pity.
A few moments later.
Yes, that's what it was. This monitor's auto detection is not very good. So it's actually, don't think it's to do with the cable. I think it's just due to the fact that it was still on display port mode when it was connected to the computer. Yes! It works! Look at that! There we are. That's my mouse. I know that's really normal, like if you just had a normal DisplayPort cable or HDMI cable, then that wouldn't be cause for somebody to celebrate like a madman. But that's with fiber cable. So 50 foot or 15 meters of fiber cable is here, and this could be running, you know, up my walls, it could be going from one side of my house to another. And then with the RUIPRO aka detachable fiber cable, I think I got the name right, it works. So that is it. Demo over. So that wraps things up. It's a pretty interesting idea and a pretty interesting product. I'll put links in the description if you wanted to check this product out yourself. If you've got any questions about it though, then please do drop me a comment. And if you enjoyed this video, please do click the thumbs up button and please subscribe to see more videos like this. Thanks for watching.